Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over two examples. One involves the calculation of the length of an arc, and then the second involves the area of a sector. Before we get started with the computations, let's go over the formulas real quick. So let's write these down, formulas. So the first formula is for the arc length. Arc length. All right, so the formula for the arc length is S is the length of the arc equals theta times the radius. Okay? And then the formula for the area of a sector that is given by A, let's call it A equals theta over 2 r squared. All right, so those are your two formulas. All right, so geometrically, what do these formulas mean? So let's go ahead and connect these formulas with this diagram I have right here. All right, so I have a circle, and then I have a section cut out. You can think of it; it could be like a slice of pizza or something like that. Now, the length of the arc is basically the distance, is a one-dimensional measure, is basically the distance from here all the way to there. So it's like a portion of a whole circle. So how do you compute that distance? Well, you just need to know what the angle is and what the radius of the circle is. And then you input it into this formula, S equals R theta, and that will be the arc length. Okay, so this distance right here is, this is your arc length. Arc length, let's try that again. The arc length, and the formula is S equals theta r. All right. Now, what is the sector or the area of the sector? The area of the sector is a two-dimensional measure. It represents the sector that's enclosed by these two radii right here. Okay, so this area of this region, this portion of this entire circle, is a sector. So the region that these two radii enclose is known as your sector, and the area of the sector is given by A equals theta over 2 times the radius squared. Okay, now these two formulas, you've seen them before. You might not realize it, but you actually have. If you think about the formula for the circumference of a circle, C is equal to 2 pi r. This is a special case of this arc length formula. Do you see what the connection is here? Well, let's say we have a circle with radius r. Okay, and then the angle of rotation is a full circle. So let's say we have a circle with radius r, and your arc length is the length of the entire circle. So if you go full circle like this, what will your theta be? Your theta is going to be 2 pi, okay, or 360 degrees, but we are working with radians here, so we're going to use 2 pi. And let's say a radius r is r. Now, if I plug these two values into the area, the arc length formula, then what will the resulting result be? So we're going to plug it into the formula. I'll have S is equal to theta times r. And if I plug in these arguments, theta is 2 pi and r is r. What do we have? This is the formula for the circumference of a circle. So the circumference is actually an arc length where the angle theta is 2 pi. Okay? And the same also goes for the area of a circle. You know that elementary formula, elementary geometry formula you saw for the area of a circle, maybe in middle school? A is equal to pi r squared. Well, it's the special case of the area of a sector formula also. Okay, how is that possible? Now we know what the area of a sector is basically the area enclosed by the two radii. In this case, the angle of separation between the two radii is a full circle, which is 2 pi or 360 degrees. So this entire region is going to be my sector, okay? This entire full circle is going to be my sector. Now, if I plug in my arguments into this formula right here, what do I end up with is the question. All right, so let's plug it in and see. So the formula tells us that A is equal to theta over 2 r squared. In this case, we have theta being a full circle, which is 2 pi, and divide that by 2 times r is just r squared. If we simplify this, what do we end up with? We end up with A equals these two twos divide out. This divides with that. So we end up with A is equal to pi r squared. So this is the area of a circle formula that you've seen in elementary geometry showing up. So this is in fact the special case of the area of a sector formula. So bottom line is you've seen the area, the formulas for arc length and area of a sector before, but probably you weren't even aware of it. All right, so there goes the derivations. All right, now let's apply the formulas that we have here to these problems. That we have on the side here. Let me create a partition so we do not get confused. All right, so there goes your partition. Let's take a look at question number one. All right, so let's take a look at example one. So for example one, we asked to calculate the length of the arc. The length of the arc right here. So let's write down the formula first. The formula is S is equal to R theta. In this diagram, we're looking for the length of the arc. So what is that? The length of the arc is basically the distance from here all the way to the distance from here on the extremity of your circle, the distance from there all the way to there. Okay, so that's what the arc length is. How long is this line, this distance? So this formula tells us that we need two things, the radius and the angle. So in this case, we see that the radius r is 6 meters, and the angle theta is 5 pi over 6. Okay, so let's plug these two arguments into our formula for the arc length. That gives us S equals R, which is 6 times 5 pi over 6. The 6s divide out. And then your final answer is going to be 5 pi meters. Okay, so let's put this in a sentence. The length of the arc, the length of the arc is 5 pi meters. Geometrically, what does that mean? It means that the distance from this point to this point right here on the extremity right here is going to be 5 pi meters long. Okay, so that's how you calculate the arc length. All right, let's shift our attention to question number two. Question two, we are asked to find the area of the sector. So what does that mean? Geometrically, if you examine this object right here, what does the area of the sector mean? If this is the angle under consideration, then the area of the sector is basically this area, this region right here, enclosed by these two radii separated by an angle of pi over 3 radians. Okay, so let's see. The formula for the area of a circle, A, is given by theta over 2 r squared. So all we need is just theta and r in order to compute the area of this sector. So theta, the angle, is given by pi over 3. And then the radius r is equal to 15. So the area of the sector is pi over 3 over 2 times 15 squared. Okay? So let's simplify this. This looks kind of complicated, so how do we do this? Pi over 3 divided by 2. Let's see, how about we express this denominator as a fraction also? So how do we divide two fractions? What we do is you multiply the numerator, the fraction of the numerator, by the reciprocal of the denominator. So if you reciprocate 2 over 1, you have 1 over 2. Because division is the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal, okay? Times 15 squared is 225 over 1. One cool thing about this product right here is that 3 is a factor of 225. So 3 goes here, 1, 3 goes into 225 75 times. And then if you multiply across, multiply the numerator, 75 times 1 times pi is 75 pi. And then the denominator, 1 times 2 times 1 over 2. Okay, what's the unit here? You multiplied, remember you multiplied a length by itself, so that's going to be a two-dimensional unit. Centimeter square is going to be your unit. All right, so let's write down the meaning of this. So the area of the sector is 75 pi over 2 centimeters square. All right, so that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to my channel to get more cool updates to videos such as this. And please post a comment to let me know what you think about this presentation. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.